I think the next thing that we do is we do the silent sitting. So you are welcome to do whatever you want in the silent sitting. I've taught people in the past, if this is the first time you're listening, in the past I've told people some meditation techniques that they can do. Maybe I'll tell it again because I haven't told it for a few weeks. So basically, just so that this really excites you and makes you ultimately motivated to do this, is that what I'm about to tell you, firstly, is not meaning to imply that there is somebody in there that can do something. And secondly, so it's not that there's no doership in this. And secondly, it will either happen or not happen. So you'll either follow what I say or don't follow what I say, and that's not actually down to you or your choice, because that is illusory. And thirdly, this meditation practice will not lead you to enlightenment. No meditation practice will lead you to enlightenment. No practice will lead you to enlightenment, because who gets enlightened? Who? So the meditation practice might calm the body-mind mechanism down, it might calm your habits and conditions down, but your habits and conditions aren't a separate entity that can get enlightened. They're simply something that's appearing, and you can change them. To me, what liberation is the end of attachment to them, the end of the belief that I am a habit and condition, I am a thought going in time. But who is this person? Who? Who? So the recommendation practices that I will tell you about is the I am practice, where basically it means putting your attention back into presence, into that sense of beingness. Not I as in I am a person or I am a form in any way, but this amness, which is prior to form. So that sense of being. So that's one practice, is just keep repetitively putting your attention back into presence. And then the next practice is the metta bhavana. Mindfulness of breathing. And that is that you follow your breath. So in every in-breath, you count one, and then two, and you count all the way up to 10 on your in-breath. And when you get to number 10, you come back to number 1 again. So when you're in breath, you go 1, in through the nose, out, 2. And the way I was taught it is like when you feel that breath going into your nose, you count. And then when you get to 10, you come back to 0 again, and you just keep doing that. So those are the two different practices. And then also there's the other practice where you just do nothing. You just sit there and then see what happens. Okay. Okay, we can begin. Let me just check everything is working. Looking good.